my channel Kridanu Updates. This is Computer Science Chapter 1, Unit 1 and the heading is Functions. So in this, I had already uploaded my part 1 video about all these topics. So kindly check the playlist link. I had attached the playlist link in the description. I had attached the playlist link in the description box of this video. So kindly check the description and check out the playlist for next videos. Please subscribe and follow my channel. So in my last video, I had wind up with this recursive function, I think so. So I'm going to start with the syntax for function types. The heading is the syntax for function types. It is in page number 3. So this is part 2 video. Here there are some syntax, that is 3 types of syntax they are given. So the x tends to y, the next one is x1 tends to x2 tends to y, then next one is x1 x2 up to xn, that tends to y. These are the 3 types of functions, function types. What is the difference between these types? Let me see. First one, x tends to y, it means x, all the x values are mentioning the input values and all the y values are mentioning the output values. So a function's major process is it has to get some input and process and it has to send the output. That is the work of function. Here, kindly note that all the input values, that is x, x1, x2 are differing with each other. But check out the y value, that is the output value. All the output values are same as stable as y. It didn't mention as y1, y2, y3 like that and all, it didn't mention here. So the first one is x is input value that is sending to the function. It is processing and it is executing and it is giving the output as y. That is first type. And the second type is x1 is an input value and another input value is x2. So a function is getting 2 input values x1 and x2 and processing it and returns the output as y. This is another type. So third type is up to xn it can get an input values from main program or any other subprograms. Wherever it is, it can get n type of input and it can process it and it can send the output as y. These are the types of functions. Here a small note is there, all functions are static definition, there is no dynamic function definition. It means that all the functions are static, stable one. The method of processing the statement is a stable one in functions. There is no dynamic function definition at all. It means that there may be a difference in getting the input values, but the processing method, the processing definitions will be the same as stabled one. So it is called a static function, static definition. The next heading we are going to see is interface versus implementation. So kindly friends, subscribe my channel and don't forget to press the bell icon. Keep watching. So what is interface and what is implementation and what is the difference between these two? These are the headings we are going to see. So interface is a set of action that can object, that an object can do. For it means interface is nothing but it will act as an set of action. That means what kind of work they has to do. Likewise, it is instructing a work, that is known as interface. Consider the interface heading as a manager in a concern. What is the work of a manager? A manager has to instruct other employees to do what is the work. Likewise, the manager has to instruct them. It doesn't mean that he has to do some work. Just his work is instructing other employees to do some set of works. That is known as interface. What is implementation? Implementation means the workers who are all working under manager is known as implementation. What is the work of workers? They has to get the instruction from manager and they has to work for it and give the output. So implementation is the process of work, and Interface is nothing but definition of a work. What kind of work they are going to do? Interface is nothing but an instruction, and implementation is nothing but the definition of work, that is the work. How the work is going to take place, like that. So, a manager only can do what other workers should do. So, see the difference. Interface just defines what an object can do but won't actually do. It won't do any work, but it will instruct the work. Implementation means implementation carries out the instruction defined in the interface. So, what are all the instructions given by the manager? It has to be implemented by the workers. So, that is the major difference between interface and implementation. Next heading is characteristics of interface. There must be a characteristic of interface. You know, then only all the other workers will follow that instruction and they will implement. So, a manager definitely should have some set of characteristics. So, what are the characteristics? Point number one, the class template specifies the interfaces to enable an object to be created and operated properly. What kind of work they has to do, only a manager should separate some people to instruct them what they have to do. Likewise, he is creating a place to work. So that is the main character. The second one is an object's attributes and behavior is controlled by sending functions to the object. So second is he has to give some machines, or he has to give some equipments, and he has to provide some place, some space area, everything. All those things are comes under the word attributes. So after allocating all the attributes, then only the other workers will function for it. The other worker will implement the process of manager, implement the instruction of manager actually. So he has to keep some control over the process, and he has to control the workers also, then only the work will get fulfilled. So these two are the major characteristics of interface. Here there is a simple example. A person is driving a car. Consider it as an example. So a person is driving a car, in the sense he has to know the driving concept, the mode of driving, that's all. It doesn't mean that he has to know how the wheel is rotating, how the engine is rotating, how the car is getting fuel, how it is getting speed. Likewise, all the blah blah blah, there is no need of all those blah 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 to the driver actually. Only the driver's motive is he wants to drive a car, for that he wants to know the driving, that's all. So only this task is mentioning that it is an interface. That is, the accelerator is working as an interface between the car and the driver, and the driver only, the basic knowledge is the driver must know the terms of driving, that's all. He doesn't want to know how the car is working. So in this case, so if a person compulsory wants to know how the car is working, how it is rotating, in the sense it is known as implementation. So the next heading is pure function, and we are going to see about impure function.